Alright. Hey guys, I got Tyler Tamman after round two. How'd you do?
Well, not too hot. If you guys, you know, remember Philly, I have a tendency to lose to 12-year-olds. And that exact same thing happened today. I just got 2-0'd by another 12-year-old Dragon Duel. He comes up to the table, he's like, oh, Tyler J? No, who are you? So game one is very simplified game state. He books my Zen Mighty, and he has literally no cards in hand or field. I'm like, okay, if he doesn't draw a monster, I win. If he draws something, I'll be in decent shape.
Mm-hmm.
But the monster he does draw is Guaiba, so I cry. And then game two, before I'm even done searching off Factory, he lets me know he's going to heavy me and then summon Guaiba and shows me it. I'm like, oh, okay, that's fantastic. And then sets 4 back row.
Right.
So that was fantastic. And then he said it was very, very easy. So I was just heaps of upset.
It's salty injury.
Yeah, so I just got to invite a 12-year-old. Yeah, that's the moral of the story.
All right, good luck next time, man.
Thanks.
Hey, guys, we got Joe Giro. Paul Clark here after round two. How'd you do?
I just played wind-ups. I won.
Nice. Anything particular happened that round?
Nothing too crazy. I mean, I had this one play where I had, like, Scrap Dragon and Red MD going.
Uh-huh.
But, like, eventually, I got him down to, like, not a lot of cards. It just, he had one card left, and he drew Reborn on my Scrap Dragon.
Uh-huh.
Tacked over my Dark Flare. Then used Scrap Dragon, killed this set card to kill my Red MD.
Nice.
So, like, I had to top deck something, and I drew a Sorcerer. So, because of that, I 2-0'd him.
Nice.
Otherwise, I probably went to game three, and who knows.
Right, right.
Those wind-ups.
So. All right, good luck round three. Hey guys, we got Pat Hoban after round two. How'd you do?
I won.
Nice. What'd you play?
I played against Dragoonities.
Cool. Anything happen that round?
Yeah, game two was crazy. He did some kind of crazy combo that I don't even know. He was so strong on his rulings, too. Like, he knew everything about the new stuff.
Hmm.
I was really impressed.
Nice. All right, good luck round three.
Thanks.
All right, we got Jeff Jones after round two. How'd you do?
I won. I played against Heroes. It was pretty simple. The only thing that kind of bothered me is he decided Silver Sniper against me. So, like, I undeaned a marksman and, like, popped it. And then it kind of, like, set me back a turn. But
right, right.
But, yeah.
All right, so 2-0?
Yep.
Sweet.
No, we played each other.
Hey, guys, we got Joe and Billy Break here. How'd you guys do after round two?
Well, we played each other, so he won and I lost.
2-0 creams.
Yep, again, 2 wins in a row. Yep, so round one, I played Paul Levitin, 2-time champion. Round two, I played Joe Orlando, the guy I played round one of the last event.
Anything you want to comment about this round?
I mean,
I'm macro.
Yeah, you played macro. I mean, tour guide off the top, but it's okay. Like, it happens.
Right, right.
I mean, anytime you play a friend, you know, it's always bittersweet. Like, it's bittersweet for him. It's fine. It's like,
we'll play later in the
day. Yeah, it feels better. Like, you know, at least I lost to someone. Better do well. Last time I lost to him, I won the next 7 in a row. So, fingers crossed it happens again.
Nice. All right.
Top, isn't this only 10 rounds?
Yeah, I know, exactly. Yep. 7 in a row. Let's go.
All right, good luck round three.
Yep.
Cordero after round two. How'd you do?
I lost to a friend of mine. A famous friend around here. Reynolds. I lost to his Chaos Dragons. He too old me.
Really?
Yeah, I did a play that I shouldn't have done because the whole time he had a set face down. Every time I tried to use Priestess Effect, he always popped it. He always stopped it with a Veiler.
Mm.
And the last time, I'm like, okay, I'm about to get an attack. I should have Dark Hold him and Chain Wisdom, but the whole time I thought he had Tremendous Trap Holes face down. His face down was still the recharge. So then from there, he got on his turn, he drew up Light Sworn and then Solar and then kicked my butt from there.
Right.
And game two, I didn't draw. Every time I upstart, I didn't draw the card I needed.
Mm. Cool.
But every time he reasoning me, when he hit 7, I hit 10 and hit Trigodi on the field.
Nice. What's the best call for reasoning? What number?
In my deck?
Yeah.
You call 7. If I don't hit 7, I will just say, like, okay, you call 7, I'll hit 3. I get my Tempest Magician. I'll play a spell book, and then no matter what, I'm still getting Priestess out.
Yeah.
If you hit a Veiler or a Spellbook Magician, I'll just Wonder Wand it, and I'll still get a plus off of it.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool, no matter what, I'm always getting the plus.
Yeah. Sweet. Good luck.
Thank you.
Go Simon after round two. How'd you do?
2-0 Heroes. Game one. He was, like, shuffling his hand, and, like, an honest, like, came out on the table. And he put it back in his hand, like, set it, and then set 2. So I went Torgai Leviathan, and then he compulsed it, and then a turn later I went Magician Shark and Zen Mighty and Shockmaster and all that, and just won. And then game 3, he had 2 cards in hand, and I went Zen Mighty Shockmaster, called Spells, and he drew a 3. He went Photon Thrasher, Alias into Utopia, swing over Shockmaster instead of back row.
Mm-hmm.
So I used Zen Mighty's effect to get Rat, get Rabbit back, and Solus Over Mountain is face down.
Mm-hmm.
I also had a shark from the Shockmaster thing last turn. I summoned Tsukiyomi, flipped the Utopia down, exceeded with the shark into my own Utopia, and then just won.
Nice.
Mike Steinman for president.
Tsukiyomi.
All right.